Let's talk about visualizations. So the collisions, this is actually real data that I was able to pull from a website. And I created a little mini data mart. That website is New York City Open Data. And this has a list of all automobile accidents over the past 8 or so years. I said, well, this is probably kind of interesting data. And it covers, you know, the boroughs within New York City. So if we want to create this visualization, we can go ahead and pick up this query. This query is going to join my fact table collisions with all the locations that these collisions could have occurred. And the location provides more information, such as what is the borough that the collision occurred in. And I'm going to sum the number of injuries for every row within the fact table, but group by the year. So I'm going to get a total for 2012, 13, 14, et cetera. One of the reasons notebooks are so exciting is the text, which is marked down, and the query that you want to run, but it will also store the results of your query. This is simply stored in another JSON file. So I can go ahead and run this. And it returns, okay, I'm gonna run that off of the car crash connect. And there we go. So it just refreshed that. And that's all well and good, but it doesn't necessarily give you a lot of impact from a visual to quickly understand what these numbers mean. There is within the notebook itself a charting capability, but I think this is a little green at this stage. So it doesn't really give you, well, if I click on it, it's kind of hard to configure and it's just not, you know, terribly meaningful. But what you can do is you could take this query and then open up a connection to the database and run the query within a SQL editor window. You get the same results. But within the SQL editor window, you have this option, which is called Visualizer. So what we did in the notebook was chart, but Visualizer is an extension. So in order to get this icon, you have to go to your extensions and you'll see one that's called SandDance. If you enable this extension, it's really easy. You just go up here in the marketplace and you just type SandDance. Of course, this is already installed, but then you would click on it to install it, and it just takes a minute. And then you'll get this icon over here for the visualizer. So taking the very same query, I can click on that visualizer, and now I've got a column chart that is a little bit more informative. So I can see I've got 5 boroughs that are reporting here. They're color-coded where the fewer injuries, it's red, and then the more injuries, it's green. That's not actually our first choice. So I can come over here and I can reverse that. And so now it's the red that indicates a lot of injuries. The green would indicate fewer injuries. And so now I can look at all these and I can see that Brooklyn would end up with more injuries or the most compared to these boroughs, Staten Island, the fewest, et cetera. I can also get a 3D view of this data. And I can also on the Z-axis, we have the X and Y, but we can add the total injuries to the Z-axis. And this gives us now a better perspective on where the injuries occur. So bottom line is it's most problematic in Brooklyn, and by a significant degree, it's the safest in Staten Island. Now, perhaps they don't have as much traffic there, and that could be what's going on. Okay, if you want to change from boroughs to year, we could do year. Okay. We can look at 2012, 2014, 2016, 2018, and see if in fact we have an increase year over year. And it looks like there is a pretty consistent uptick from year to year for accidents, perhaps more cars, more traffic. So in short, you're really just a couple of clicks away when you use Azure Data Studio and with the extension of SandDance, being able to analyze and more quickly to understand your data.